Hi, welcome to Fix by Doc, and we received another package from Olight. They sent me a couple more flashlights to review. So let's open this up here, check out what we got. Alright. Okay, so Olight sent me the S1R baton, which is 900 lumens. They sent this one to me for free, as well as they sent me the S2R baton for free, which is the 1020 lumens. We will do a individual review of each of these flashlights, and then we will do a combined review so that you can see the comparison of the two flashlights. This one uses the RCR123 batteries, and 123A batteries, and this one uses the 18650 batteries. They are both rechargeable flashlights using a magnetic mount USB charger, which is pretty cool. And they have a bunch of really neat functions. Each of these flashlights come with a 5-year warranty, as the package says right here. And they have some really cool features if you like features with flashlights. As usual, the Olight packaging gives the important details right here in front on each of the packaging. Then on the sides here, they show what the packaging comes with and the type of batteries, which they do come with the rechargeable batteries required to run their lights. So that's a plus, so you don't have to run around trying to find a place that sells the batteries, because some of these batteries are hard to find, like 18650s are actually kind of hard to find, in my area anyway. And then in the back of the packaging, you get the list of all the, the breakdown of the details of each of the flashlight in a more detailed manner. So, the packaging, I've always loved the packaging from Olight. And you get the nice clear windows to see the flashlight.
This is a quick review of the Olight S2R baton. I'm super charged about this because it's rechargeable. It was sent to my husband for free by Olight to get a good review and a dunk test and a drop test. I'll make him do the drop test because I hate that. But I'm charged about it because it's rechargeable. And I'm probably going to say it a couple more times because I'm excited about that. It has a bunch of different modes. And since I haven't got them memorized, I'll read them. It starts with turbo. And it starts out at 1,020 lumens and then drops to 500 lumens. It'll stay at the highest lumens for 2 minutes and then 190 minutes more of that lower mode of turbo. And then I guess that's when the battery dies. But it also does a high mode, 500 lumens, and it can do that for 200 minutes. The medium mode was 120 lumens for 13 hours. We're starting to get into hours now. Low mode is 12 lumens. And that's 120 hours. And the moon mode is a half of a lumen, 0.5 lumens, and that's for 60 days the battery should last. It says it has 5,800 candelas. It is 2 meters waterproof and impact to 1.5 meters. It is in length, 105 meters.
So moral of the story here is if you're going to go backpacking and you store it in your backpack, make sure it's set to the moon mode in case it turns on accident.
It's actually got some really cool features to actually do something like that. And it's not meters long. It's 105 millimeters long. Mm-hmm. It is, which is about 4 inches, 4.1 inches. The bezel diameter is 23 millimeters, just under an inch. It weighs 101.5 grams or 3.6 ounces, including the battery, which it was sent with, which is super cool. And this is the battery, I'm assuming that it's the battery they use for their testing. So if you put a less cool battery in, we'll get less cool results. Let's see.
Light bulb, what kind of light bulb does it have?
It's got a CRE, there it is. A CREE XM-2, sorry, L2 LED.
So CREE XM.
Okay, yeah. Includes a 3,200 milliamp hour 18650 rechargeable lithium ion battery, which recharges through the cool magnetic thing for the tail cap. And
uses the 18650 batteries.
And let's see, there's a lot of other really nitty-gritty technical stuff. I don't think there's anything that is super in-depth right now, but I'd like to show you this part is the part that goes to the bottom, and it magnets on there.
What is that part?
This is the charging cable, and we'll show you that to a little power pack thing, just to see the whole fun light colors it does.
So this is a USB charger cable that connects to the bottom of the flashlight via a magnetic mount.
Yeah. So now it's plugged in, just to let me know that there's power running to the magnetic bottom part. And if I put the flashlight on there, it may or may not, it's not going to because
it's fully charged.
But this will turn red when it's up there. I'm draining power from it, so it's charging in. So it's red now. When it's fully charged, it will turn green.
So that'll charge off of any USB charging device.
Right.
Or your computer or anything like that.
And it also in the box came with a really, I just want to like rub this and like snuggle it, teddy bear
fuzzy. Do that again
fuzzy,
so I can see it. Okay.
Like teddy bear fuzzy package. It's probably not real velvet, but it's super, super fuzzy and soft. Little pouch for storing it all together. And it comes with
wrist strap.
Yeah, the wrist strap with the little like bent wire that's kind of needle shaped.
Cotter pin.
Yeah. Basically a cotter pin for putting the wrist strap easily through that little hole in the bottom. And then you can tug it through and then double it back on itself and then it's attached. But we'll leave that off because we're going to get this wet in a minute and I don't want to have a wet strap on there. Stuff it back in here. Let's see. The instructions it came with look like a massive amount of information. Never panic. Only like a teeny bit of that is actually English. It's got amazingly lots of different languages so that anybody who wants this might be able to read it. And even if you don't speak any languages really, other than like you can know what numbers are, it has a lot of pictures to tell you all the important information there.
So how far can we drop this thing?
1.5 meters, I think, which is over 4 feet, I think. Mm-hmm. I love that they tell you in the manual not to stuff it in your eye, and they also tell you not that they did not include an actual USB power source, because somebody probably asked them.
So let's drop this thing and... Whoa, I'm slipping here. Let's drop this thing and we'll turn it on first.
I was going to say, make sure that it shows
so
off.
So there it is. It's on and it works. So now I'm going to drop it about 2 meters. I usually hold them out in front of me.
One Ryan chest high.
And there it is on the ground on the rocks. Let's do it again. I'm running through the woods. Bump into a tree. Drop the flashlight on the rocks. Still working.
And you're going to be nice and drop it on a stump too.
Dropping it on an old oak stump.
A rugged stump. Wow.
And it bounced off the oak stump and landed on the rocks. So that's still working.
All right.
And what's the, how deep can we drown this thing?
2 meters, but what it's going to get is an Addy arm.
One Addy arm. It can go 2 meters underwater, but it's going to get one Addy arm into a 50-gallon barrel.
Which is about what most of the ones we test get.
Yes. So here's the flashlight.
And then we can even demo the modes in there. Yeah. I'm going to turn off my...
Well, we don't want to... shift through the modes in there if you want, but we'll demo the modes out of the water.
That's definitely October temperature water. All right, it's on.
Give it a good swirl and shake around. Yeah, push the button a couple times.
The one thing is I'm just not used to where the button is on it, and it's not like a uber rubbery button, so it's... There we go, found it. Yeah. On and off. Going through high, medium, and low. Turboing it. Off, on, off and on.
It says strobe. If I
can, there we go. Get it to strobe and not strobe and on.
All right. Survived. So let's go back here and, over to our stump. It's getting dark out here. In about an hour or so, we'll be able to do the official light test of the flashlight.
Do we need to go through the modes now, or do you want to just do that while it's dark?
Go ahead and go through. Just shine it on your hand. Or shine it on my hand. Yeah, it's really slippery there. Shine it on your hand or shine it on my hand or shine it on the stump.
My headlamp is off.
Start out with turn it off and put it in moonlight mode, which will hold it for 2 seconds.
Press and hold the moonlight.
There's moonlight.
This is moonlight. That's, I think, a half a lumen.
Yeah.
And then off.
Turn your headlamp on so we can...
I'll put my headlamp on moonlight as well, and I'll aim it off to the side so we can do that. Okay. So then press it on.
Moonlight is 0.5.
Yeah.
Next one is 12. Go one at a time.
Okay. Sorry.
So go back to moonlight.
Yeah. Okay, off. Press and hold to moonlight.
Okay, that's moonlight. It's 0.5 lumens. The next one is 12 lumens.
This is low.
At low. The next one is 120 lumens. The next one, 500 lumens.
Okay, and then you want
and
me to
And then
try
the turbo, is...
I'm still having trouble double-clicking with my thumb. There we go. I think I got it to turbo.
And that's 1,020 lumens.
That's, yeah. There we go.
And then do the strobe.
And that's triple-click.
Okay.
My thumb is slow.
Before okay. I get sick.
Back onto moonlight. So it remembers what I turned it off in... It'll remember turbo as high mode. It'll remember moonlight as moonlight. So if I turn it on and I take it to, say, medium, and then I turn it off, it'll come back to medium.
It'll never go to turbo mode.
But, yeah.
Yeah, it'll only go... If you turn it off on turbo mode, it'll come back on high.
Right.
But
it also does...
All the other ones, it'll come back on whatever mode you left it on.
It does a timer, two different timer settings, which is cool if you want to read in bed and think you're going to fall asleep or something with your flashlight on and, like, discharge the battery too long. You have to turn it on, and then you press and hold for... No, it's double tap and then hold it. And the one blink says 3 minutes, press and hold. Two blinks says 9 minutes, and then I turn it off, and I think when I turn it back on, it should be out of the timer mode. There's also a lockout function, and let me see if I remember that really quick.
Are you sure you know how to get it out of lockout before we
yes,
lock
I did it.
Out?
I already turned it on and off of lockout, so their instructions are very clear and easy to understand okay. about the lockout mode. My headlamp is facing sideways, and I'm trying to... Where did the English go? I think it was basically... Okay, you turn it off, you double tap... No, it's like you're going into moonlight, but you just hold it down longer.
Okay,
that's lockout. Now, when it's in lockout, you can turn on the moonlight mode by turning it, like, pressing it. And if you press and hold it again, I think that turns off the lockout mode. But, like, if you desperately need
so
the light,
press and hold for 2 seconds, moonlight comes on, continue to hold for another second, and then it's locked out.
Yeah, and you get that flash. Okay. So that's cool, because if you need it while it's in lockout mode, you... Off? Off? Press and hold. All right, that's moonlight. I gotta off, press and hold longer. There. So if I have it locked out, and I really, really need to see something, I can turn it on to moonlight. And it'll kind of come on again. That will be the first thing you see. But then, you know, like
that'll
you were saying...
That'll last 60 days.
Yeah, in moonlight. So you were saying, you know, it would be cool if you could lock it so it wouldn't mess up in your backpack or something. Or you can just unscrew the tail cap a second. Mm-hmm. Do you want to see the battery real quick?
Yeah, okay. Turn your headlamp on a little brighter so that we'll be able to see. That's good.
All right. And we'll use my handy-dandy shirt. Very technical item for drying items off. It's definitely a wicking material because it was one of my running shirts. Mm-hmm. So it ought
and this
to be...
is a 3,200 milliamp hour, 18650 rechargeable battery.
Rechargeable, which is super cool. Yum. Well, that's bizarre.
What are you looking for?
I thought I read in the manual that it said that the nub goes in first, but I guess it came up that way, so we'll put it back in that way.
Yeah, the nub goes towards the toe cap.
That is so bizarre.
So, there it is. There's the battery.
It's a pretty color.
3,200 milliamp hour, 3.6 volts, 18650, rechargeable lithium ion battery.
Uber cool. For high drain devices.
High drain devices.
Sorry, I put my light on it.
These Olight batteries are really nice. They work very well.
And so. I don't think we demoed this one, but it does have that magnetic tail cap, which means it can stick to metallic objects that are magnetizable.
Yeah. So we'll go ahead and stick it to this pole here.
On. The only thing I would worry about with this flashlight, like I said about the other one, if you've seen that review, I might worry that dropping it repeatedly onto the and end it of it is. That charges, you might damage that end and have it hard to charge.
And it is a very strong
watch it
magnet.
Wiggle. It makes the pole wiggle when you pulled it off. Yeah. Yay, but that's cool.
And this, I'm not sure that we would damage it too.
You'd have to really be obsessive about dropping it on its tail end repeatedly, over and over, which I can't see. And they've recessed the one part so it won't actually cause a circuit when you put it on something metal.
Got a water drop on there, but
that's
other than that.
My finger. Yeah, do you want to tell them about your. I don't have good pockets. Yeah. And you really do like that drop clip.
Yeah,
or whatever
it's got
you call
the clip on here, it's got the drop down. setting. So most of the time a pocket clip stops right here, so the top of your flashlight sits above your pocket. This one, with pretty much all Olight flashlights that I've seen, they keep the flashlight sitting flush with your pocket lip. So they're nice and
stylish.
Nice and out of the way there.
I really like it.
Whether you have it on the outside or concealed on the inside.
I might just borrow this flashlight from you.
Addie's already talking about stealing my flashlight.
Adopting it?
That's okay.
You've got so many. How do you take care of them all and give them all the attention they deserve?
Yeah.
You can even have the fuzzy pouch because I know you really like pouches.
Yeah. So, we'll see. She already stole one of my headlamps.
They sent it technically to you.
Yeah.
So, it's up to you.
Yeah.
If you want to do it.
All right. There you have it. When it gets a little darker out here and the sun has fully set, which is over there and it's setting right now, we'll come out and we will do the, when it fully sets, we'll come out and we'll do the light show in the dark and we'll see how far these things shine. So, all right. Talk to you later.
Yay.
Okay. So Addie has the
S2R baton.
All right.
Baton. No, that's two T's, baton. And here we go, showing you the off mode. That's a really easy one. And here comes the moonlight mode, which is a little brighter than regular moonlight. We checked because the moon is out, but we're behind trees. Here is the low mode. Medium.
Shine medium down the street.
Shine it. Oh, hey, there's one of those markers for stuff. I don't know if we can see it down the street, too. There's the backside of a sign. And that speck down there, if you can see it or not, is the mailbox.
Mm-hmm. And the
413
next
feet. This should give us high.
And that's like 500.
Back down to moonlight. And that should be the turbo. And I think that is 900? No. 1020 lumens max.
Okay. Come over here and shine it down the street.
Shine it down the street. Shining it down the street.
Okay.
And you can see the trees on the side of the road. It is lighting up a fair whack of space.
And then you go out in the field.
Out into the field.
There we go, now it's focused. Can I see it for a second?
Sure. I want to go see if I can get some eyeshadow on spiders. That's always fun.
Alright, now we can actually see the end of our tree line.
Yeah,
those trees nicely. You see are quite a distance away, about at least 200, almost 200 meters away, about just shy of 200 meters away is that last tree down there. But we have my GPS on us, and we're going to see how far away we can see Addie when she goes down the road. So
I have to leave the flashlight with you?
Yes. And so to turn this on is I do it the same with mine, right?
Yeah.
The double click?
Yeah.
All right. So why don't you...
If you cycle through it, you get low, medium, high. If you want moonlight, you have to put it...
Why don't you go start at the mailbox. I'll turn the light on when you get to the mailbox. Turn your headlamp on so I can see you. And you got the little orange reflector thing with you. Okay. So when you get to the mailbox, I'll turn the light on. I'm standing here, which is 413 feet from the mailbox.
Is that you or a car?
Just me.
Okay.
She's almost there. Okay, I'm going to turn your light on, bright. And wave your orange thing around.
It's in front of me.
Okay. We'll have to wait till the vehicle passes. We'll come back in a second. Okay, now that the car is gone. See that speck down there? Find a button on this thing. And there we go.
All right. I can see her with my eyes. She's down this telephone pole past the one that you see on the camera. She's at the one past that. Stop!
I'm not moving.
Okay.
I'm waiting at the mailbox for instructions.
Okay, the camera can't see you, but I can. So I'm just gonna have you go until I can't see you.
Right.
Wave your orange thing. All right, stop.
Okay, so we're at 0 feet. I'm gonna walk down to Eddie.
Said I think
0.12 miles, so it switched from feet to yards to miles, and we're 0.12 miles, so whatever that equals to
it's
meters.
1/10 of 5,280.
Yeah, so.
Which means 500 feet.
Yeah, so that's about right.
Did you stop because like I just disappeared?
Because I couldn't see you anymore. So
okay, because right. When I turned around, I couldn't.
So, all right.
Hey, there's something about the flashlight that I just realized because I was reading the package. Yeah. Apparently, I haven't run it down yet, but around the light, the button to turn it on, when the battery is low, it says there's a glow function around that. Yeah. So you know the battery is low.
So right here with that glow function right there.
Because like
it won't go to 1020 anymore because it died out when I started walking to you.
Okay, then I must have had
it. So there's the flashlight.
We must have had it in high a really a long time.
Well, I had it in high the whole time while you were walking away.
Well, that's convenient that it did
so,
that. Though.
Yeah. So, for the next video clip, we have to charge the flashlights now so that we can do a comparison of the two. So, we will come back to you after we charge the flashlights and do the next part of the video. All right. Talk to you later.